tell you what, go ahead and introduce the man coming to the ring. They tell me the legal department's on the phone for me.
Wait a minute, legal department's on the phone for you? Now what have you said?
We're talking about copyright. Copyright what?
Oh, is this infringement?
I'll call you back. I don't know what their deal is down there.
Oh, you've got some problems, though, don't you?
One too many lawyers, I can tell you that. Elix Skipper in the ring, the youngster from the power plant to face Gene Romeo. Little Hubertu Guerrero impersonation here.
Well, these are two young guns from the WCW training facility in suburban Atlanta, Georgia. The World Championship Wrestling Power Plant. These are two graduates with an opportunity here on WCW Saturday night to make a name for themselves.
Loaded down with charisma, Kid Romeo comes to the ring. Incidentally, I would be remiss if I didn't just fall at your feet and bow in reverence that you didn't throttle Juventud Guerrero at the announce position 48 hours ago on Thunder. How did you get through that?
That was quite an experience. I guess it's just the powers that be, well, their attempt at humor. I thought it was a rip. Juventud Guerrero coming out to be my color commentator for 2 hours this past Thursday night on TBS.
Unbelievable.
You don't think we're going to have to put up with him in the future, do you?
Yes, I do.
Well, you know something
it's
I don't?
Well, no,
what,
I don't.
What did they tell you?
No, they haven't told me anything.
You talked to the powers that be, didn't you?
Well, yeah, but I mean, they didn't tell me anything about that.
What were you talking to them about?
Well, just things,
right here,
you know.
Right now. Spill the beans.
I can't tell you.
You can't tell me?
No, I can't.
You're going to keep me out in the cold in a situation like this.
Well, it wasn't,
you're not going to clue in everybody watching WCW Saturday Night about a conversation that you had. No, really, make it official. Is Juventud Guerrero a new official WCW broadcaster? Or was that just a one-night aberration?
That, I don't know. That wasn't what we talked about. We talked about the new Saturday night. We talked about the changes on this broadcast.
Well, I hear there's quite a few changes, but nobody will tell me any specifics. What do you know?
We may be adding a few segments to Saturday night. The wrestling will stay right here where it's always been for 27 years on the Superstation at 6:05 on a Saturday. We may be adding segments to the show.
Am I going to be involved?
Of course. Are you kidding me? The Professor? Iron Mike? Hollywood Mike? The artist? Well, you know.
How many nicknames do I have?
I don't know. I need a book. I'm going to get legal department to quit making phone calls and get me like a turtle. I keep up with that stuff.
Well, these are two of the young men from the power plant that we've really been impressed with in recent weeks, and I think it's just a matter of time until an Elix Skipper, a Kid Romeo. Oh, there goes Kid Romeo! Great cross body block!
Momentum down into a lateral press. Skipper rolls a shoulder at two, but Kid Romeo firmly in control here. Shoots Skipper hard into the turnbuckle. Romeo waits on it, charges in, corner mouth. No! The hot shot from Skipper!
I was going to say it's just a question of time until one of these two young men, or maybe both, get an opportunity to go to a WCW Thunder, a WCW Nitro event, and you know, talk about getting a chance. Power plant graduate Devin Storm, they're going to toss him right into the fire tonight against the Canadian crippler Chris Benoit. I'm not sure that's the kind of opportunity that you really want. What a spectacular move by Skipper.
Lateral press and no. Romeo out at two. And I'll tell you what, you know Devin Storm will not underestimate Chris Benoit. No way, no, hang on. Sunset flip, no. Nice escape out of the powerbomb attempt by Kid Romeo, but Skipper putting the boots to Romeo. Storm is not going to underestimate Benoit, and Benoit is not going to underestimate Storm. You're going to have two men with a lot of respect for each other going into the ring later on tonight, but Benoit. Well, look at that. Skipper walking the ropes, double slant into the shoulder.
Well, phenomenal agility on the part of Skipper. Hooks the leg.
Whoa! Romeo rolled a shoulder at two.
This past Thursday, I was a guest on WCW Live, the internet talk show at WCW.com, and everybody wanted to talk about these young stars of WCW Saturday Night, like Elix Skipper, and the fact that we often see moves from Skipper that we've never seen before. Belly-to-belly, cover, and another two count. You know, I've pointed out that much like when the cruiserweights and the luchadors arrived on the scene here in WCW a couple of years ago, they revolutionized the sport with all these new moves. think we're seeing a variation on the same thing with these youngsters from the power plant.
I could not agree more. Like we say week after week, save your tapes of WCW Saturday Night. In a couple of years, you want to go back and take a look and say, boy, that must have been one of Elix Skipper's first matches on television, or one of Kid Romeo's first matches on Saturday Night. Great nostalgia, great party stuff when these two men are superstars in this sport. Butterfly, double underhook, and it was suplex from Skipper. Romeo down, not a textbook cover, and Romeo rolls the shoulder.
Yeah, did not have great weight positioning on that attempt at the pinfall by Skipper. But the thing I do like when I watch the offense of an Elix Skipper is the fact that he's putting moves together. It's all about chain wrestling. It's putting him in combinations to take your opponent into that compromising position where you can go for the three count.
And in the ropes, body scissors up top, and the bulldog from Kid Romeo. Now go Skipper. Skipper has had things going his way this entire contest. And Romeo, that may have been everything he had left, but it was effective. Driving the face and the chin of Elix Skipper into the canvas. Both men staggered, both men down. Referee Charles Robinson putting the count to these two athletes. Romeo back up to his feet. Skipper's back up. Forearm to the jaw. Oh, and a right hand from Romeo. A forearm and an exchange developing in the ring. Oh, the knife and chop from Romeo, and one more.
Well, just when we thought Kid Romeo was being totally taken care of in this match by Elix Skipper, it's time for him to mount an offensive. Nice drop kick on target.
Spinning heel kick, drop kick, full front slam into a lateral press, and Skipper kicked out with authority at two, but Romeo still in control. Skipper, in the last 30 seconds, has just been hammered by Kid Romeo. Whoa! Flying Hurricane Rana from the ropes to the corner, and no, and Skipper kicked out at two.
Now still fight left in Elix Skipper. Kid Romeo trying to put him away. Telegraphed the back body drop, and he paid for it.
Certainly did, to the chest, to the gut. Whoa! European uppercut. Drove his lower plate to his upper plate. Romeo still down. Skipper into a full scoop. No, escape. Go behind by Romeo. Full scoop on Skipper. Oh! Back of the head to the canvas. It's home.
Oh, my goodness. How does your neck feel just watching that?
Oh, I am not moving. Kid Romeo is. Elix Skipper moving very slowly. But I mean, with that slam driver, Kid Romeo, who calls that the Romeo meltdown.